Hey guys, Clumsy here, and welcome back to Modded ARK. Look what I saw! It's a flying Rudolph! just roaming around the place and I saw this guy here. Annunaki Genesis. You guys are insane. I like it. So let me try and tame this Rudolph guy here. It's far from Christmas, it's just me, but what can we do? He's here already. And he got stuck. You're mine now. Can I knock you down like so? Perfect. Okay. Alright, so let me go down here. One sec. There we go. Let me get my solo one and only golden treat. All others have expired and oh crap. Can I not access your inventory? Because you're stuck inside, or is it not a is it a passive tame or something? Anyway. Oh well. Let's just kill it then. Be right back, guys. I have a plan. I found something, guys. A poison drake. Although it's only level 100. Because right now, as I'm recording, the bug is still there. The dino level bug. But let's try and tame this. Let's maximize this opportunity that we saw a low level drake. Because I think if it's a high level drake, we won't be able to manage it. So, I know I mentioned that I didn't want to tame anything while the level bug was still there in the center. But yeah, I thought maybe it's for the best. Maybe low levels are the only things we can handle for now. Because look at this guy. He is super scary. Yeah. Crap. Torvor isn't building that much, so that's good. But we have to be careful. So I have to keep behind him all the time. So he won't have a chance to breathalyze me or something. Alright, is it running away now? I think it's running. And what is that? Crap. Enter Warden music. It's the Giga Warden. Peace. I come in peace. Oh crap. Did it just fart or something? Because look at my health, and it even gave me some torpor. That must be a giga fart. Okay, here we go. Alright, we can do this. Crap. If I knock you down here, will you fall below the seas or something? Ah, to heck with it. Let's just do it, because this drake isn't going anywhere. Alright. Come on. There we go. It's down. Now we just have to pray. It bounced. Okay, I think it's good. It's going to land somewhere there. Alright, perfect. Now, any baddies around? Yes, there are, but we should be able to manage them. Okay, crap. These bats need to take care of them first. And these spiders and these RGs and everything is just going here now. Crap. Okay, there we go. Now it's clean. Now let's get some stuff here and tame our drake. Wow, look at that unconscious meter. Alright, it's eating prime meat. Let's feed it. Oh, okay. That was super fast. Alright, that's good. Level 146. And crapper. Yeah, some scorps. Let me get on here. I hope I don't get knocked out. Yeah, I think I'm fine. But this is cool, guys. Finally. Even though it's low level, but we'll make it work. We'll level it up. And we'll see how it goes. Anyway, everything is still low level right now because of the bug. So we'll have a chance to rule the skies, so to speak. Let me just think here. Can I clean you up? This drake has some BA fire breath. Poison breath, that is, but it's still able to kill anything. Awesome. Alright, I'm back at base. It's time to make a saddle for this guy. I don't have a name for it. If you have any idea, let me know, okay? BA Drake, Rake Saddle, there we go. And I wonder what materials we need. Let me see. Saddles. That one. Okay. Alright, there, lag. Okay. This should be feasible. Shouldn't it be that hard? Only thing is keratin might be an issue, but everything else we should have enough of. Let me just see here. Yeah, should be okay. Let me get this, that, keratin, charcoal, and let's see if this is enough. Boy, this is quite far. Alright. Okay, so let's put everything here. We're missing, where's the hide? Oh, here. And keratin. Alright, I'll go get some of that, guys. Alright, here we go. Let me land here. And, wow, perfect landing. Alright, keratin in. Craft that Drake saddle. Okay, perfect. Now we have the saddle. Let's test this out, guys. On our BA Drake right here. And let me get back first the materials. Just so our inventory is clean. Alright. Throw all those away. And presenting. BA Drake with saddle. Incoming. Beautiful. Beautiful. This is one of those... Actually, this is the dino that I was looking forward to the most. You know, because it's basically a small dragon, right? Let's pump melee damage here so we can just knock out stuff. It doesn't contain the best stats because it's really low level compared with normal Anunnaki levels, but it's a start. It's a good start. And if you can see below there, there's a Giga. But that's our Giga. I left it on aggressive, so I got and tamed the Giga and... left it on aggressive below, just so it will clean up the place. Oh my goodness, this is awesome. Fire breath with right click. Poison breath. And one shot, Pteranodon is down. Nice. So we have a ranged attack, which deals massive amounts of torpor and is able to deal splash damage even. It's an area of effect. And what is this? We can actually attack while on land. Alright, fire breath. Is it still up? Alright, still up. I can attack it like so, and it's running now. I can run for it. Nice! So it's not like a normal bird. You can actually attack on land. It acts like a normal land dino when landed. And when you fly, it acts like a flyer. Awesome! Two dinos in one. Crap, I forgot to press the record button. But we have this guy here now. It's a downed BA Poison T-Rex. It's also low level because of the bug, but it's still a Poison T-Rex, you know. And I think Punisher is feeling a bit lonely. Although I think this is also male, so maybe he just needs a friend. So I don't know. Let's just tame it so we have a green T-Rex around the base. It's, what is it? Yeah, it's fairly low level, but I'm still gonna tame it, and this will take a while though. I'll have to feed it lots of narcotics because the food is nowhere near down. Crap, and look at that, it almost woke up. Alright, so it's been like 10 minutes and I decided let's just feed it prime meat. Maybe it will be not so bad. Alright, there we go. That was super quick. I shouldn't have needed to wait anymore for that golden treat. Anyway, we do have a level 179 T-Rex now. A poison T-Rex, awesome. And we can think of it as a low level Anunnaki terms, but perfect tame vanilla terms before the center was implemented, right? Alright guys, I'll be right back. Look who I found! Do you remember this guy? It's our first ever pteranodon. The one we tamed after Annunaki. Oh my goodness, it's alive. Do you remember this one? Where I said it got bitten by an elite boa. It took 2 bites and it was down. It ate it and it ate me. Apparently, it wasn't eaten. It just was sleeping all that time. Cool. Although we don't really need a high-level pteranodon that's basically not BA, but still. It's alive, guys. He or she is alive. I forgot. Ah, it feels so good. I'll bring this guy back to base. Okay, so I have a plan. Another plan, yes. Our Drake is intended to tame other drakes in the future. Some high-level drakes once the bug is fixed and we get high-level dinos. But first, we have to craft some prerequisites, specifically this guy here, the chemistry bench. Ah, that's noisy. This guy has all those prerequisites, those requirements, but we have all of them. And this acts like a high-tech mortar and pestle. So let's see how much XP this gives. Not really a lot. Alright, but anyway. A chemistry bench is a chemistry bench. Let's get all of that. And now we can dispose of our mortar and pestles. This is cool. Because I don't really like the look of it. They're so primitive and we have stargates and fabricators and everything. And let me just get that neat spoiler there. And we deserve a more high-tech mortar and pestle. And in order to do that, let's plop this down. Okay, perfect. How does that look? Looks all high-tech and stuff. It's powered, alright, perfect. And how do we use it though? Okay, so it requires gasoline and power. Boy, this guy is needy. Already have power and you want gasoline? I was trying to move away from that kind of model. But anyway, we have lots of gasoline, so let me just take half of it, and let me take some berries. Okay, so the reason why I wanted the chemistry bench is I want to have a very fast mortar and pestle. And I want to have a fast mortar and pestle because I am trying to make some potions, which I'll show you in a bit. But for now, let's go and turn this guy on. Wait, let's put maybe all the ingredients first. Let's make narcotics. Turn it on. And there we go. Is it fast? I think it's the same speed. Oh no, it's making 5 at a time. Alright, that's cool. Yeah, look at that. I wonder what it says in... okay. So 4 at a time. Alright, that's cool. And alright, to make this guy, we need spark powder and stim berries. That's much faster. Alright, we need lots of stimulants because that's required in our next step. This is kind of noisy. Let's just get everything here. And one sec. Alright, one sec. Look at that, guys. Looks very fancy. Much better than a mortar and pestle, right? Alright, this one. Agility booster is what I'm trying to build. Stimulants, medjo berries, and crystal. The agility booster is something that you can feed to dinos, and it restores their stamina to maximum instantly. Although there is a cooldown, like 20 seconds, I think. So you can only drink a potion every 20 seconds, but you don't need to drink every second, right? Because what I want for this is our Drake should be able to fire breathe, poison breathe, infinitely. If we have all these agility boosters, just return all of these. And that's so cool because the poison breath gives out a massive amount of torpor in one go. And if we're able to spam it, maybe that should take care of high level drakes and all that high level stuff that we can tame. At least that's the concept. But yeah, that's why I need a lot of those. And I also need a lot of these health boosters. So in Annunaki, they have health boosters where you can create them by narcotics, tinto berries, and crystal. And this is also feeding for dinos. And this is insta-heal. So from 0 to 100%. Well, not 0% because that would be a dead dino, but you know, you get the picture, right? So with these guys, we'll be able to tame and survive high-level dinos. And yeah, I think this is a good plan. Awesome. We will be able to test it in a bit. What better to test it with than another poison rake? Poison rake? Poison rake. Where is it? One sec. There it is. What level are you? I didn't see. 100 plus. We should be able to manage. Alright, so let me spam this poison breath. And crap, look at our torpor. But since we are able to spam poison breath a lot more, I'm expecting we should be able to make it. Alright, yes, it's running away. Alright, there we go, it's down. Yes. We managed it. Alright. Although, look at our torpor. Oh man, we almost got knocked out actually. I think that was one more breath and we would have been the one getting knocked out instead. Crap. Yeah, this is bad because this is just low level, level 100. And should I tame it? Maybe not. Yeah, it's fairly low level. Let's just get it for some levels for our own drake. And I have to think of something. So I've been thinking about it. And it seems like I do need to buff the stats of my dinos. Because Annunaki, the same with other normal mods, and in ARK in general, wasn't really designed for single player in mind. Like, yeah, you can play single player, but you will be handicapped. It's more a team effort type of game, right? So in beating the Wardens, the Ubers, the Primals, and all the other strong dinos, it's not really intended for one person to do it alone. But since I'm doing it single player, I think it only makes sense that I buff the stats. So yeah, that's what I'll do. In the next episode, I will find a way how to buff the stats, the health, damage, and stamina, maybe, of the tame dinos so that we have a chance in killing them solo. Alright? But in the meantime, I was trying to get the feel of how this drake works, and I think I have more or less an idea now. So what do we know so far? So far, we know that this drake can fly. But what are the particulars? We know that it can land, and even if it lands, it can run, and it can even attack using its arms and mouth, like so. But on top of that, when you rotate, it also rotates with you. When you move your camera, it also moves. That means its turning radius is absolutely perfect, unlike the T-Rexes and other large dinos. So it's always facing where you're facing, right? Amazing. Even if when it's flying, it does that. And what's cool as well is even if you go underwater, you don't get booted out, like so. Normally, when you're a flyer, when you're on a what the heck is that sound? That sounds so scary. Is that a drake? Looks like it. Super creepy sound. But where is that sound coming from? It's disturbing me. Anyway, yeah, but we don't get booted off, unlike other flyers like a RG or a Quetz or a Pteranodon. If you go underwater, normally you get booted out. Here, you can actually swim. Well, it doesn't swim, it just walks on water. But we can even fly from here, like so. So we don't need to fear anymore going underwater and killing some stuff underwater, because we can always dive and fly back out, like so. Perfect, right? On top of that, we also have, it's also cool because it's like a Quetz that it can stay on the air indefinitely. Like, let me drain something. If I right click, It uses its breath and look at my stamina. My stamina is being drained so quickly. Like I have, I think, 3,000 stamina now. And it's still getting drained immediately. Look at that. So I can't just spam it all throughout. But if I stay, even if I'm flying, look at my stamina. Upper right corner. Not there. It's filling up. And now we're full. So we never need to land, actually. We just need to go stationary for a while. And stamina goes back up. Perfect. I like it. On top of that, left click, attack, right click, breath. And the... how do you call it? Because it's control in my key bindings. But the barrel roll of the Pteranodon, that key, it instead... it's for picking up dinos, I think. I think we can test that out right quick. Let me see. Okay, here we are. Let's test a trike. Can we carry a trike? Not really. Can we carry a smaller dino? I don't know, a turtle? Not really small, but... no? What can we carry? A dilo, for sure. Or an oviraptor, is it? Did I carry it? Oh, yes, I am. It's a floating oviraptor. Okay, so we can carry small dinos. That's fine. Pteranodons for sure not. Yeah. Trikes, we know we can't. So maybe it's like a Pteranodon that it can carry only small dinos. Not really the best, but it's still useful. Maybe a Lystrosaurus. For sure, we should be able to carry this guy. Yeah, it's right there. Where is it? There we go. And we can drop it like so. Oh, I'm wondering, can we attack while it's carrying something? Can it attack what it's carrying, like an RG? Okay. Did we carry it? Yes. Alright, so let me try to attack it. No. Oh, look at this. Inverted camera view. For the win. Didn't know this was possible. Alright, but anyway, let's let go of that Lystrosaurus and just fly back here. Alpha alert, where is that? There. A prime alpha dodo. Anyway, yeah, that's gonna be it for this episode, guys. I really love this Drake. So amazing. But we really need to buff the stats because we're not a match for any of the high-level dinos. So in the next episode, after this lag is done... that was quite some lag. After in the next episode, I'll take care of that, and hopefully we'll have stronger dinos that can take care of more elite dinos in the future, right? But in the meantime, let me face you right here. Awesome angle. In the meantime, that's gonna be it for now. I hope you enjoyed that, guys. If you did like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more updates. In the meantime, this is the Clumsy Geek signing off. Thanks for watching, and have a nice day. Bye-bye, and for you, I leave one poison breath. See you guys in the next one.